Good morning, students. So let us go on zoology class. So we are discussing chapter 5, molecular genetics, right? And today we supposed to discuss the topic regulation of gene expression, right? So here first of all we have to know what is gene expression. Then we can see how this gene expression will be regulated. Right? Okay. We can come to the point, what is gene expression first of all, right? So where is the gene? Of course, the gene is present in this DNA, right? Okay. And so this DNA will be transcribed as mRNA, right? Then this mRNA is translated as protein. Okay. So come to the point here. So now the DNA consists of the genes as a codes. This is now expressed as a protein. For example, we can say if there is one of the protein insulin, we can say for example in the human beings, once insulin, it is a protein, right? So who is responsible for the synthesis of this insulin? The code which is present here. So this gene or this code is expressed as an insulin here. Understood? Okay. Now, and so this gene expression is now regulated or controlled. Okay. So why should it has to be controlled? Whatever process in the body, it must be regulated, right? So we may need this, you know, little amount of this insulin. So amount of insulin should not increase or you should not reduce. So it must be regulated, right? It must be controlled, right? So that we can say regulation of gene expression. Okay. So this expression or regulation of this gene expression may occur in three places, in three spots. So what are the sites this may occur? The first one, during transcription process. So during transcription process, this gene expression will be regulated. What do you mean transcription? When the DNA is copied as mRNA. So during this process, you know, this gene expression will be controlled or regulated. The second choice is it during post-transcription time. So what do you mean post-transcription? After transcription, what are the process takes place? Of course, this tRNA will collect the amino acids from the cytoplasm and the tRNA will read this mRNA as per that it is collecting this amino acid. So, these are all the process may take place after transcription. Okay. So, during this time also, this regulation may take place. Fine. And the third duration is a translation time. So, during translation also, what do you mean translation? Here, this mRNA will be translated as a protein. So during this translation also, this regulation may happens. Okay. And who is, you know, initiating this process or who is involved in this, you know, regulation process? Especially here they say intracellular and extracellular metabolites trigger initiation and inhibition of gene expression. So which one? This metabolites which is present inside the cell and outside the cell is triggering this either initiation or inhibition. If we need to synthesize, the process will be initiated. So if we need to stop this synthesis of any one protein, this process will be inhibition. So either initiation or inhibition, it is triggered by this metabolites which is present in this intracellular as well as extracellular region. Have you got the point? Okay. Now, here I introduce one of this new term that is known as operon. So, operon is nothing else. This operon is mainly involving in this process of regulation of gene expression. So, operon is playing the major role there. Okay. So, first let us see what is operon. Okay. So, the cluster of gene with related functions are known as operon. Usually, in eukaryotes we say, one gene will express one character or one function. But in especially in prokaryotes, they say few genes or cluster of gene is, you know, expressing one character or doing one function. Have you got the point? So the cluster of gene is doing one function, but in case of this eukaryotes, single gene will do single function. Okay, so here that is known as operon. So cluster of genes with a related function is known as operon. Okay, and in case of this E. coli, Escherichia coli bacteria, there is 260 genes are there, but it is located in 75 operons. 260 genes located in 75 operons, which means what do you mean? Cluster of genes, 75 operons are there, the number of genes is more. So these operons consist of more than one, you know, genes, cluster of genes. Is it clear? Okay. So now let us see regarding the structure of this operon. Okay, how this operon will be there. So if you see this operon, it consists of, first we can come to this region, this P, actually this P. Okay, the third one, P region. So this P, it consists of one P and O. So this P denotes promoter, right? Okay, then, and this O denotes, it says operon. And after this O, operon, it consists of this, you know, structural genes. Structural genes are Z, Y, A. Okay, then before, prior to this promoter, it consists of I. Actually, this is inhibitor, or we can say this is a repressor. Inhibitor or repressor. Okay, and prior to or before this I, again it has one P that denotes promoter for this I. Promoter for this I. Understand? So what are the regions for the P, O? P denotes promoter, O is operon, Z, Y, A is a structural gene. Before P, one I is there, that is initiator or repressor, initiator, inhibitor or repressor. And before I, one P is there, that denotes promoter for this I. Promoter for this I. Have you got? Okay. Now, so this is the structure for operon. Okay. Now, one of the example for operon is lac operon. One of this example for operon is lac operon, or we can say it is lactose operon. Lac operon or lactose operon. So, in case of this lactose operon, how can we say the structure here? The same P site is there, O site is there, and the structural genes are there. Now, these structural genes are mentioned as lac Z, lac Y, lac A, to denote this, you know, lac operon or lactose operon. Understood? So, the structural genes are mentioned with the letter lac Z, lac Y, lac A. Okay. And what is the role of these structural, you know, genes? So the lac Z is responsible to synthesize beta galactosidase enzyme. And lac Y is responsible to synthesize permease enzyme. And lac A is responsible to synthesize transacetylase enzyme. Okay. So this is this, you know, functions of this structural gene. Okay. Then, and actually, what is the role of this lactose operon here or lac operon here? So, when this E. coli, when the E. coli or bacteria is consume this lactose, right? Lactose is one of the sugar, right? So, when it is consuming this lactose sugar, when it is, you know, taking this lactose sugar, that lactose sugar must be, you know, converted as, or it should be metabolized. So it has to be metabolized inside this body of this bacteria, right? So listen, actually lactose is the food of this bacteria. So the lactose bacteria is taking the lactose now, right? So when it take the lactose, actually it cannot consume this lactose as lactose because it is one of this, you know, disaccharide form. So that's what. And this lactose must be hydrolyzed. It should be converted into its simplest form. That is the process, metabolic process. Okay. So for this process, this only these enzymes are used. Okay, so the actually what is the process now? The lactose must be converted into glucose as well as galactose. So for this process, these enzymes will be used. So first we can see this role of these enzymes. First of all, this enzyme permease is permitting to the entry of lactose inside this body of the bacteria. Because of this enzyme only, first of all, this lactose enzyme will enter into the body of this bacteria. So after entering, what we are doing, beta galactosidase is hydrolyzing this lactose. What do you mean hydrolyze? During hydrolysis, this lactose will be broken down into glucose as well as galactose. Okay, now this glucose will be consumed by the bacteria to get the energy. Okay, then the next one is transacetylase. This also helping for this beta galactosidase for to hydrolysis process. That's what here it is written. Transfer acetyl group from acetyl-CoA to beta-galactosidase. So this acetyl-CoA is transfer acetyl group. So it is transferring the acetyl group to galactosidase for this hydrolysis process. Anyhow, overall we can say these three enzymes are required for the metabolic process of this lactose. That's all. So these three enzymes are required. So these enzymes are produced by these genes now. Have we got? So this gene only going to synthesize these enzymes now. And this enzyme is responsible for the metabolic process of this lactose in bacteria. Okay. And now how it will be regulated? That is a process now. As we said, regulation of gene expression, right? So how this synthesis of these enzymes or synthesis of this mRNA will be controlled or regulated? That is a process. Actually, it is one of this process. And now let us see how it will be controlled by this, operon and operator, all those things. Have we got? So this regulation of gene expression process is explained by the two persons, that is Jacob and Monod. Okay. And they say, when the cell is using this normal energy, for example, when this bacteria is using the normal energy in the sense, what do you mean? When it is using the glucose for its energy. Okay. And what will happen? Can you watch here one, it is given in the textbook. So here it is a promoter, operon. This is a structural genes and it is inhibitor. And this is a promoter for inhibitor. Okay. And so this is this, gene which is present in this bacteria, Escherichia coli. Okay. Now, this Escherichia coli is going to use or consume this glucose for its energy. Okay. So when it is using the normal energy means when it is using the glucose, what will happen? This inhibitor, I gene, transcribes a repressor mRNA, and after its translation, a repressor protein is produced. Understood? So when it is using this normal glucose, this inhibitor gene will transcribe one mRNA. From this gene, one mRNA will be synthesized. Have you got? So from this gene, one mRNA will be synthesized. Okay. So this mRNA will synthesize one protein. That protein is now, it is known as a repressor protein. So this gene is now going to synthesize mRNA. That mRNA is going to synthesize this protein. That protein is known as a repressor protein. Okay. So this repressor protein, what happens? This is used to bind with this operator region. This is the operator. So this repressor used to bind in the operator. When this repressor protein is bind to this operator, this process do not take place. From this, structural genes, this enzyme will not be produced because it is stopping the process. It is a repressor, inhibitor. Understood the point? If it is bind here it is mentioned, RNA polymerase unable to bind to the promoter. So hope you may land in this transcription. So transcription means what do you mean? The DNA molecule will be synthesized as is mRNA. So to begin this mRNA, RNA polymerase enzyme has to bind with the promoter region. And unless it binds with this promoter region, this process may not begin. Okay. So since this repressor protein is bind with this operon, this RNA polymerase enzyme cannot bind with this promoter region. So the process do not start to synthesize this mRNA, lac mRNA now. So now this is started, initiator is started to mRNA, but this process is not going on. So this is a stopping region. Understood? It is regulating. Now we need, for example, and this bacteria is now consuming this lactose, we can say. Lactose, if it consume lactose, of course the lactose must be hydrolyzed into glucose and galactose. For hydrolyzing process, we need these enzymes, as we said now. For hydrolyzing process, we need this enzyme. So where from this enzyme is produced? From this gene only the enzymes will be produced. Okay. So how it will be regulated? How it will be operated now? So now listen. I is producing the repressor mRNA. Repressor mRNA is producing this repressor protein. Now who is coming now? This is this, you know, lactose. Now lactose is acting as a inducer. Why it is inducer? This is a lactose. Have you got? Now it is why it is inducer? Because now this is going to act with this repressor protein now. When it act with this repressor protein, it will change the structure of this repressor protein. It will make it into inactive repressor. So you cannot bind with this operator region. Understand? This operator region is nothing else. This is a operon. Have you got? Operator region only known as a operon. Either it's a operon region only consists of the operator region. The cluster of genes is doing the similar function. It's known as a operon. Have you got the point? So now this inactive repressor, it became as an inactive repressor. So it cannot bind with this promoter region. So if there is no repressor protein here, automatically what happens? This RNA polymerase enzyme will bind into the promoter. If it binds, of course it is starting the process, next process. Of course, this from this gene mRNA will be synthesized. So lac A is synthesizing this lac mRNA. So this again, this lac mRNA is synthesizing these enzymes, beta galactosidase and permease as well as transacetylase enzyme. It is translated as these enzymes. So from this genes, mRNA is produced, that is transcription process. From this mRNA, now these enzymes are produced, that is translation process. So now these enzymes are, of course, as we said, it is going to convert this, you know, lactose into, you know, glucose as well as galactose. Then this glucose will be consumed by this bacteria. Understood? So that is this process of this, you know, gene regulation of gene expression. So this gene actually must be expressed as these enzymes, but it is controlled by this now, you know, repressor gene, and this operator region or promoter region is controlling this site. Unless operator region start this process, it may not happen. So this is the controlling region. Is it clear? So that's all about this, you know, regulation of gene expression. Is it okay? And please go on, so we can complete it here. And please go on this topic, that is the regulation of gene expression. So here they can ask the questions like, you know, explain this lac operon or lactose operon concept. How this gene is regulated in this lactose operon or lac operon. Okay, so that this points with this diagrams you got to give as a 5-mark question. Okay, so otherwise they can ask what is operon or what are the enzymes are essential, the enzymes which is required for this, you know, lactose metabolism. So the lactose metabolism need what are the enzymes. Okay, and what is the role of these enzymes. Okay, so what are the structural genes are located here. So these are all these questions may be asked as a either 2-mark or 3-mark question. Otherwise, lac operon concept you have to learn as a 5-mark question. Understood? So please go on these questions and please learn and write. So and do all the work periodically and don't waste the time. And we can meet in this next class with the next title. Until that, please stay at home and do your work perfectly and pray very well. Fine. Thank you.